Hello everyone, and welcome to this course, C++ Programming by Example. My name is Paul Chuklos, and I am the author of this course. Before we get into the course interview, I just want to tell you a little bit about myself. I've been working professionally with C++ for about 3 years, and my background is in biomedical engineering. I work for a small life sciences company where we specialize in preclinical cancer research equipment. In my spare time, I also like to code and contribute to open source projects, so generally I consider myself a C++ enthusiast. You can find a lot of the things that I've learned and little tips and tricks on my blog, developerpaul123.github.io. When I'm not coding, I also enjoy personal fitness, quadcopters or racing drones, sports, and other outdoor activities. You can also find me online at GitHub at developerpaul123 and YouTube on my YouTube channel, developerpaul123. Additionally, you can contact me via email. Now let's take a look at the course overview. In section 1, we're first going to introduce C++ and Qt5. Qt5 is a GUI framework, a graphical user interface framework based on C++ that we'll be using later in the course to build desktop applications. However, first, we're going to be building what are called command line applications. Starting with section 2, we're going to get started diving right into the language and building a virtual die application, where you'll build essentially a dice that you can run on your computer and roll just like you would any other dice. In section 3, we're going to build a sorting application. In section 4, we're going to build a casino guessing game application, which you can actually play with another person. In section 5, we're going to build a library management system. Then, in the second half of the course, in section 6, we're going to get started and acquainted with Qt5 by building a Hello World style application. This will serve as an introduction to the framework and will show you the many capabilities that it has. In section 7, we're going to build a very simple text editor. And in section 8, we're going to build our most complicated and exciting project throughout the entire course, a desktop painting application that you can use to create art on your desktop computer. Now, what are the course goals? Well, there's 4 main goals. One is to learn the C++ syntax and industry standard style. There's many different opinions on what is proper C++ style, but I'll be showing you what I've seen to be the common standard in the professional setting and is widely accepted. I'll also show you how to develop and architect C++ apps in a modern and maintainable way, and also use the latest ISO standards in coding C++. If you don't know what ISO is, ISO is an organization that defines various standards for programming languages, for applications, for software, so on and so forth. So C++ adheres to these standards, and these standards have changed over time. That is what the 3 numbers refer to. Those are different ISO standards, with 17 being the latest. So we'll be using the latest ISO standard in our code, so you'll be up to speed on what is the most modern way to write C++. And finally, your goal here should be to develop simple yet fun C++ and Qt5 desktop applications, which is exactly what we're going to be doing. Now, why should you take this course? Well, if you're taking this course, you definitely want to learn about C++, but maybe you don't know how to get started. Or on the other hand, maybe you're anxious to start coding right away, and you don't want to get bogged down with all the theory and all the little features that are available in such a large language like C++. Well, then this is the course for you. And speaking of that, I want to outline briefly what this course is not. Again, this course is not a deep dive into the C++ language. It's not going to go through every single feature, every single class, every single built-in type that's available in the language and show tutorials and information on every little part. It's also not a tutorial on the standard template library, which is available with the C++ 17 ISO standard code. Instead, we'll be making use of various language features, and we'll also be making use of the standard template library. And I will explain all the needed concepts as we go along, but we're not going to go in depth into everything. The prerequisites are quite short. A programming background is helpful, but not necessary. You will, however, need a modern C++ compiler, whether that be GCC, Clang, or MSVC, which is included with Visual Studio, but the only requirement of these compilers is that it supports C++ 17. You also need CMake, which is a build tool for C++, but you won't need to know how to write CMake code. I will provide all the CMake code and setup for you. And lastly, you're going to need a passion for learning and C++ and a desire to dive into the language right away. And that's what we're here to do, to dive into C++ by example. So let's get started.